welcome back, and we're on the home stretch now. Before we look at the papers, LeBron James has come out. His agency, that's why I had to rephrase that. His agency, I've come out to say, is going to La La Land. Yeah. And the question is that, does that move, as it is right now, increase his chances of winning another ring? Or it decreases it because the West is stocked and packed?
No, not even that. You know, the fact that he's made this move already, you know, or we hear that his golf course is going to make the move, not bringing other superstars into the picture, you know, to maybe build a super team. You could now see, you could say maybe he just wants to play basketball now, and he doesn't want to chase rings anymore. But we can't tell for now until the free agency is still on, because there's still the Paul George, of course, is signed with OKC. There's the issue of Kawhi.
They're chasing him.
Yeah, he's still there. There's Boogie Cousins, you know, DeMarcus Cousins, who is also one of the best centers in the league. And so there's still, it depends on what the moves the Lakers make. We know the cap space they have and everything. So it's still going to be very interesting to watch. Then we would see. If it's just LeBron and their core
and
the young core, then I think we should expect to see Lakers like Boston of this season, you know, where maybe getting to the conference finals will be able. If you have any team and you have a LeBron around them, even if the team is decent, they have a huge chance of doing something. So you will never never write them off.
No.
But let's just see let's see if they'll get another superstar, or they'll wait to the end of till next season's free agency, where the likes of Kawhi will be an unrestricted free agent. You know, Kevin Durant just signed a new deal, but is one plus one. So meaning that he could also still be in the market, you know, for next season, and might
stop
be
dreaming.
So a lot of things.
Stop dreaming. Let's look at the papers now.
A lot of scenarios.
Because anyway, LeBron just wants a big star to join him. Let's stop dreaming. Focus on this season and see how many players you can actually get in. Time to look at the papers now. We'll start with Complete Sports here. Interesting from Complete Sports, Saudi club ready to splash £40 million on Musa. Please don't go. Algeria sets to hijack Gennett role from Nigeria. What?
If he was your husband, would you tell
him? He won't go. Saudi Arabia, no way. He can go to resume AFCON qualifiers in September, of course. Bayern join race for Marseille. Yeah, it's going to go. Juve work on shock Ronaldo deal. He's not going to go to Italy. We know that. Okay, Sporting Sun here. Croatia set up Russia quarterfinals, and Gennett Rohr may dump Super Eagles. Okay, top shortlist for Algeria. Now you have it on Complete Sport. You also have it for Sporting Sun. I'm not sure he's not going to dump it. Algeria don't have as much money as we say it's going to stay.
Mm-hmm.
And Saudi club also tempts Musa with 40 million quid.
Interesting. Lastly, for the papers, Chinasia, last word. On Saturday, we saw two of the greatest players of all time. Cristiano Ronaldo and Lionel Messi crash out off the World Cup without scoring a knockout goal. Is it too early?
Messi
to
had
say,
a deflected goal.
Is it? Yeah, well, that's not his
and
goal.
An assist.
Just your last word. I mean, is it too early to say, okay, this guy's perhaps will not win a World Cup in their careers?
This
they're going to
be
37 and 35
at the next World Cup. So yeah,
yes,
it depends. It's 4 years. We don't know what Argentina might have in terms of core, and also Portugal. We don't know players that might be coming up So they might be in the team. They might be in a team that might win the World Cup. They might not be that influential. But you just can never tell these things sometimes. Yeah.
Okay.
Drogba left Ivory Coast and he won the Nations Cup, if you remember.
Maybe they should leave so that they can win also. Alright? Yeah, before we just go quickly, I'll take this tweet coming from TJ. He says, I'm tipping Luka Modric to win the next Ballon d'Or based on his influence at Real Madrid and Croatia, as well as his achievements so far. So we're going to get a new winner. Thank you, Chinasia, for coming.
Always a pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching. I'm Cecilia Amorbe.
Enjoy the rest of your day. I'm Tahir Salah.